Hello, today we're going to talk about how next generation DPI can help improve cybersecurity products. What is meant by next generation DPI? Well, DPI is the capacity to analyze network packets at very high throughputs to provide valuable insights about the network traffic, including real-time classification of traffic up to L7. The Qosmos product line has been the market leader in DPI for over a decade. Enea's next generation DPI comprises many advanced features, such as encrypted traffic classification, detection of anomalous and evasive traffic, advanced first packet processing, extended protocol and application coverage, and cloud-scale performance. This technology is widely used in cybersecurity solutions for extended detection and response, next-generation firewalls, and other security functions. It is also useful in the telecom industry for traffic management and service assurance. Enea's Qosmos DPI is the only solution today that supports more than 4,000 different network protocols and applications. Frequently changing network apps like the ones shown here are covered thanks to continuous updates of the DPI engine's protocol signatures. Qosmos DPI also categorizes the results to simplify traffic analysis. Categories include, for example, SaaS applications, industrial control protocols, video audio streaming, gaming, and many others. For each protocol or application, a set of metadata is extracted by the DPI. For example, the URL for an HTTP flow or the call duration for an audio call. In total, more than 5,800 metadata are available today. Let's see a real-world example of this on a corporate network. The first role of the DPI is to classify each and every flow on your network by protocol or application. Here on the top left corner, you can see a graph about the bandwidth usage per category of traffic. The Qosmos DPI engine has a predefined set of categories, shown over here on the bottom right. But users can define their own categories, as we've done here. A whitelist, unclassified, cryptocurrency, peer-to-peer, and evasive. In this example, the whitelist category represents applications that we actually trust. So let's filter on this whitelist. We see that it represents most of this network's overall bandwidth, and most of it is actually encrypted, as we see in this pie chart. If I limit my view to only the encrypted whitelisted traffic, I see that the DPI engine is able to classify these flows in spite of the encryption. And we do that thanks to different classification methods shown here. So it could be metadata from the application itself, like an SSL certificate, the server SNI, or hashing DNS information using analysis or previous DNS queries to predict what the application is, or different types of session behavior, or analytics, or session correlations, all done to maintain a high level of classification in an encrypted world. Now I'll remove the whitelist filter and focus on a category that is clearly a risk, for example, cryptocurrency. Thanks to continuous updates, the DPI engine provides support for the latest popular cryptocurrency protocols and applications. Crypto miners emit low signals on the network because they mostly use CPU time and do their activity in a stealthy manner. But since they still have to communicate with the outside to give results of the mining, the next-gen DPI is able to detect these very low signals and even identify which machines are infected by the crypto miner. The DPI is able to locate where on your network, on which subnet, and on what machine in your network this type of activity is taking place. Security analysts may have blind spots when analyzing the network traffic due to various evasive methods, like creating VPN or creating tunnels in order to go under the radar and avoid firewalling or IDS policies. These different techniques are analyzed and detected by the DPI. Here we have examples of DNS tunneling, like DNS to TCP, or different types of tools or applications that are used to fake the network traffic, like HTTP injector to fake the HTTP header, or different VPN-based services. On these VPN or encrypted tunnels, it is not possible to certify the application detection. For these unknown flows, it is important to know flow details. For example, here you can see flows comprising less than 2 packets, so just an attempt to be on your network, but not the actual cause of any real damage. However, if you see 11 unknown flows with more than 1,000 packets, for instance, the IP addresses involved in this activity could be a cause for security concern. So this was an overview about how Enea's Qosmos DPI can help for cybersecurity products. Stay tuned to this channel as we'll be adding screencasts like this one, but with more details about different scenarios and different types of threats that next generation DPI can detect. Thank you for watching.